Good afternoon, everybody. So I represent Integrated Development Lab. So this year we have floated one of the project. Just like to tell you about it. It's called as OpenRAP. So OpenRAP is Open Resource Access Point. So generally you have just heard of access point as a Wi-Fi access point and all this thing. But this is going to be an open source resource access point. So what are the different resources that we are just going to explore it? So OpenRAP is used for offline localized content delivery network. You must have heard of a content delivery network during your course time for the network. So this also point towards that only. So content delivery networks, basically you have a lot of big servers and all these things are there, which is used by Alkami and many other big giants company. But they have very farms of servers doing all this work. But this is going to be a very small CDN, which is going to run only on Raspberry Pi. Have you worked, anybody heard about Raspberry Pi and worked around the Raspberry Pi? Yeah. So the, all these things, contents will be, we have to deliver through Raspberry Pi in the offline mode. Okay. So I've just given you a very basic, because this is just an origin and a one user, of course, if takes some time, but if there is a caching server or a content delivery network in between, the same content can be delivered very fast to the user. And the main load to the original server will be very, very less. Okay. So where and how we are going to use, why we are building this thing? So preloaded digital courses, like we have courses like Eggstep and IITBX or many other things which are there. So all institutions like you, if you have anything offline content on your local system, and a student can access all these contents locally, so it will be a very easy for the local colleges or institution to access those resources fast, instead of wasting the internet bandwidth every time for each and every student. Okay. So same thing is the preloaded image, preloaded digital courses or content for the schools or institutions. So again, for the teachers training reference material, offline digital library of Wikipedia and Khan Academy, because this was actually, we had just thought in terms of putting the contents for the school. So that's why I've just mentioned for the Wikipedia and Khan Academy, which allows to have one courses like for the school, if I just say if I want a whole course material for 8th standard CBSE board. So all the materials is available for me, which I can download and keep it offline mode. Okay. So I don't have to, or each student don't have to go to Khan Academy and try to refer it. Why, if it, that thing is available locally, why don't you use local network rather than wasting the whole bandwidth? So project deliveries are particularly this one. So installation and configuration of OpenRAP with Eggstep and Sunbird for local and offline and online version. Why I'm saying it's online, because Eggstep is one of the online system and Sunbird, which is going to be a local system. So again, then this is going to be a very huge task, installation and configuring this thing with various platform. This only Eggstep and Sunbird are mentioned out here, but there are various content that we have to try to configure and check it. Next is the testing. Well, since it's a Raspberry Pi which has got an onboard Wi-Fi over it, so how much that small Wi-Fi has got a capability to connect to a number of people. Okay, I can have, say, 5 people are connected, no issue. So 5 people are connected and viewing different contents, it's okay. But what if there are 10 users? Do the connection happens? Do the video, whatever your people are streaming and all this thing, the bandwidth becomes low or what? So this will be a pure load testing that we have to do, whether the Pi, Raspberry Pi, the Wi-Fi of the Raspberry Pi is able to deliver that part or not. If not, then we have to think for some other solution. Yeah, I can have a very strong access point from where I can have Ethernet, which is there on board, gigabit Ethernet, which is there on board. I can connect it directly to the high access point and try to deliver the same network. and try various hardware like Raspberry Pi Zero, the Zero which I wanted to put it because it is very much cheaper than the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi cost almost around 3000 while Zero cost around 800 rupees. But what if we try to put it in the cluster mode and try to see how it performs? Then again, for the delivering the content from the network, if we have 4G dongle or anything connected to the system and try to download it, because many of the schools or because many of the institutions like you have come from, they have the internet connection by default. You have very good bandwidth and all this thing, but many schools they don't have. So how this can be achieved with a 4G dongle and other resources where these people can connect and try to download the data? Again, as I mentioned, the Raspberry Pi, you can connect up to 128 GB of card and all this thing. But what if I want to connect, I want to store more data. So what the solution is, keeping all the database which is going to store out here, just pushing all the data on the hard drive, local hard drive, and try to extract from there. So this phase, I think the testing and compatibilities capabilities will be much thing where you are going to learn how you can tweak the streaming part or any other thing to support more and more students. Okay, so this is very brief presentation that I have given out here. And the OpenWrap, as it says, it's going to be more of a content delivery network only. Okay. Now, expertise or skill required, people who have Node.js expertise, Python, building Linux, because there will be a build which is going to happen while running the script. And some knowledge of Golang is required. So major of the script that I have seen in OpenWrap is majorly Python based, and Golang is used to build the script, final script, the image which is formed. Okay, and this image we have to put it again on the Raspberry Pi and boot it. Okay, so major chunks will be of Python and Node.js as a server. Okay. Thanks.